A Foolish Barber. Long time ago, there lived a businessman named Virendranath along with his wife Kalyani. He was very rich and kind too. There was always a long queue of visitors at his home. He was a good host. Once, he incurred heavy losses in business. People stopped coming to his place. Even friends turned their back on him.
None of my friends visit my place now. But they are not at fault either. Even if they come here, I will not be able to offer them anything. In the past, when I had money, I was generous and respectful towards all my guests. I offered them the best of hospitality, but seems all that has gone waste now. After all, without money, what can a poor man do? Now, I'm jobless. I have no money. I have no right to live. It's better for me to die. Oh, I'll think about it tomorrow morning. Oh.
Virendranath fell asleep thinking all this, and he dreamt about a monk talking to him.
You need not lose heart like this. Good people like you must live. Listen carefully. When you wake up in the morning, you will find me at your doorstep in the same body. You got to hit me with a stick on my head. I shall get converted into pure gold coins. Thus you will acquire enough wealth which will be sufficient for your lifetime.
When he woke up the following morning, he was wondering at this strange dream and thought,
"Oh, well, dreams are dreams anyway. They can never turn into reality. I shouldn't tell this to Kalyani. Otherwise, she will make fun of me."
Suddenly, there was a knock at the door.
"There is someone at the door, Kalyani. Please open it."
"It must be the barber. Who else can come so early in the morning?"
It was indeed the barber. Hardly had he started shaving Virinder's beard, there was another knock.
Wait. There is someone else at the door. I shall open it myself."
As he opened the door, it was the same dream monk, and he uttered to himself,
"Oh, impossible. This is the same monk I dreamt of last night. Oh, impossible."
It was the same dream monk, and he uttered to
"Welcome, sir. Welcome."
He picked up a baton and hit the monk on his head. The monk turned into gold coins. Everyone was flabbergasted.
"Hey, Kalyani, come here. I can't believe my eyes. We have become rich once again."
"Thank God, our bad days are over now."
Virendranath decided to bribe the barber so he doesn't disclose the matter to anyone.
Come here. Hey, Lal Chand, come here. You can also have a few of these coins and become rich like me. You know, I want to help you. But remember, don't tell about what you saw here to anyone. Is that fine?"
"Oh, thank you very much, sir. You don't worry. You can trust me very well."
Now, Lal Chand the barber was going home and planning something.
So that's the secret. These monks turn into gold coins. So that is how Virendra must have acquired his wealth earlier also.
The following day, Lal Chand took out the stick and went to the monk's temple. He found 5 monks outside the temple.
Oh, great men, I request you to come to my house so that I could donate something to you. Actually, it is an epic book and I don't understand anything. It might be of use to you, great monks.
Why not? Where is your house?
It's close by. Please accompany me. We shall reach in no time.
As the monks reached his house, Lal Chand closed the door.
Where is that book?
Oh yeah, I shall show you that also. But before that, let me accomplish my job at least.
He started hitting them on the head. Lal Chand started hitting them on the head.
Save! Oh, save! Save! He's killing us! Ah! Oh, he's mad! Someone help!
The king's guards heard their screams and came rushing.
What happened? Why are you so tense?
Oh, someone has gone mad here. He wants to kill us. We have some more monks inside who are in danger. Please save all of us from him.
The guards went inside and heard some more sounds.
Ooh, save! He's killing us. He's mad. Someone, please help.
Oh, it's strange. No monk is turning into gold coins. All my hard work has gone waste.
The guards got hold of Lal Chand, the barber. He resented going with them and pleaded not guilty.
Where are you taking me? Hey, what is this?
That is what we want to know. We shall take you to the Qazi.
Bloody fool, you wanna become a don in my town. Stupid, don't you know what kind of a Qazi is me? I am the strongest Qazi of the town. How could you dare to do a crime in my town? Why were you killing those innocent monks? What wrong have they done to you, stupid?
But sir, I also wanted to be rich. What else I could do?
He narrated the whole story to the judge.
Oh no, very strange. How could it be? Anyway, call that businessman to the court.
Soon, Virendra was brought to the court.
You are Virendra, the businessman? This person is Lal Chand Barber. Do you know him?
Oh yes, yes sir.
Mr. Virendra, Lal Chand Barber says that he has seen you hitting a monk. Is that right?
No. No, sir. I have not killed any monk. It seems Lal Chand has misinterpreted this incident, as anyone else could have done so, but it was not like that.
Virendra narrated the whole story to the judge.
Oh, that's why. No monk turned into gold coins when I hit them at their head. How foolish am I that I acted without thinking. Hey, you shut up. Not only that you are foolish, but you are also a criminal. I will not leave you like this. You will get severe punishment for your crime.
He ordered his guards to put Lal Chand behind bars. Moral of the story, don't be a copycat.
आलू कचालू बेटा कहाँ गए थे?
हम बच्चे हैं, हम सच्चे हैं, नहीं सकता कोई डरा.
Two little hands to clap, clap, clap.